हेलो हेलो
गुड इवनिंग मैम।
गुड इवनिंग। सो ऑल हैव जॉइंड आई थिंक। महेश इज हियर, मृत्युंजय, संजना, दीप्ति इज लेफ्ट, सो वी कैन वेट फॉर दीप्ति। सो स्टूडेंट, डिड यू रिवाइज द चैप्टर और द टॉपिक्स विच वी हैव डन अर्लियर इन माई प्रीवियस क्लास? डिड यू ट्राई इट? डिड यू ट्राई इट बेटा?
यस मैम।
डिड यू फाइंड एनी डिफिकल्टी? ऑल द थिंग्स आर क्लियर टू यू? ऑल द टर्म्स, ऑल द मीन्स प्रोसेसेस? महेश कुमार,
यस मैम।
यस, डिड यू रिवाइज्ड ऑल दोज थिंग?
यस मैम।
या सो ऑल द प्रोसेसेस वर क्लियर, लाइक गेमेटोजेनेसिस वॉज क्लियर टू यू? We done two things. The one was gametogenesis and the second the structure, male and female reproductive structures. So now I'm sharing my screen for the next topic.
यस मैम।
My screen is visible now. Is my screen visible to you where oogenesis is written? Can you see?
यस मैम।
Yes.
नो
No, Mrityunjay? Not. Is it visible or not?
नॉट विजिबल।
Not visible. Mahesh, you can see? Sanjana, you can see the screen?
यस मैम।
Then
यस
Mrityunjay, there is some problem in your network, I think.
मैम। दिखाई दिया।
दिख गया?
यस मैम।
ओके ओके, सो गेमेटोजेनेसिस, वी हैव डन बोथ द प्रोसेसेस। इन गेमेटोजेनेसिस यू हैव स्टडी स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस एज वेल एज द प्रोसेस ऑफ ओजेनेसिस। इन स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस यू स्टडीड द मेन सेल विच स्टार्ट द प्रोसेस ऑफ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ स्पर्म आर कॉल्ड एज, व्हाट इज द नेम गिवन टू द सेल From where spermatogenesis start?
मैम सेटल सेल।
No, wrong answer. Sertoli cell provide nourishment to the sperm. The cell which start mitosis division to make sperm. Name those cell. Anyone else? Dev Mohan. Sorry. Sorry, Mrityunjay. Mrityunjay, can you tell me?
Yes, मैम प्रॉब्लम है, थोड़ा याद नहीं रहता है।
याद नहीं रहता, प्रॉब्लम है। तो द सेल नेम वॉज स्पर्मेटोगोनिया। बेटा यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर दोज ऑल, अदरवाइज इट विल बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट इन प्रोसेस ऑफ स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस। अच्छा, दैट वाज अनदर स्लाइड। सो इन द स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस आई टोल्ड यू दैट इट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम स्पर्मेटोगोनिया एंड स्पर्मेटोगोनिया देन प्राइमरी स्पर्मेटोसाइट, सेकेंडरी स्पर्मेटोसाइट एंड देन देयर वाज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ स्पर्मेटिड्स एंड देन स्पर्मेटोजोआ। वी डिड द प्रोसेस ऑफ ओजेनेसिस आल्सो। इट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम ओगोनिया, दीज आर द एग मदर सेल, देन दे फाइनली मेक प्राइमरी ओसाइट एंड दीज ओसाइट देन सराउंडेड बाय द लेयर ऑफ ग्रेनुलोसा एंड दे आर कॉल्ड एज द प्राइमरी फॉलिकल राइट एंड आई टोल्ड यू दैट एट द टाइम ऑफ द चाइल्ड बर्थ अ फीमेल बर्थ अराउंड 60,000 टू 80,000 प्राइमरी फॉलिकल्स आर लेफ्ट इन ईच ओवरी एंड दीज प्राइमरी follicle change into secondary follicle and finally they change into the tertiary follicle. There are so many covering around them and finally what happens now they are called as Graafian follicle. The Graafian follicle is a structure which have the primary oocyte, mature primary oocyte. Now it will complete at meiosis one and will change into the secondary oocyte. And there is a process of ovulation. That is a release of ova. That ova is not actually, you can say, the result of meiosis second. It is a result of meiosis one, and that is secondary oocyte stage. Simply, in a flow diagram, you can study here. These are oogonia, primary oocyte, meiosis one, secondary oocyte, and these secondary oocyte are discharged here. You can see in this diagram, primary oocyte, primary follicle, secondary follicle, tertiary follicle, and when the ovulation occur, these secondary oocyte are released. Then what happens to the rest of the Graafian follicle? You can see here, the rest of Graafian follicle, they make a structure that is called as corpus luteum. What is the name of that structure? Corpus luteum, and it release the hormone progesterone that maintain the pregnancy. So at which stage the egg is released from ovary? At which stage the egg is released from ovary? Name the stage, Mahesh. Mahesh Kumar, please tell me at which stage the egg is released from ovary. It is released at secondary oocyte stage. At which stage it is released? Secondary oocyte stage. From ovary it is released and now it come into the fallopian tube. उसके बाद ये कहाँ आ जाता है बेटा? Release होने के बाद fallopian tube में, और वहाँ in fallopian tube if sperm reaches and it fertilize secondary oocyte, then it complete its meiosis two. Otherwise, it will be discharged in the same stage in form of secondary oocyte along with the menstrual flow. This is important to remember. The next is the menstrual cycle and fertilization. Menstrual cycle, there are the two biggest physical milestone in a woman's life. The one is called as menarche and one is called as the menopause. The meaning of menarche. Menarche means when the menstrual cycle begin, when it start. This is called as menarche. On the other hand, when the menstrual cycle is stop, this stage is called as the menopause stage. During this period, from beginning from the menarche and till menopause, the female is considered to be fertile. Considered to be fertile, it means it produced ova every month. It released secondary oocyte every month, right? When there is a menopause, now there is no release of secondary oocyte from the ovary. So what are these two terms? What are these two terms?
Menarche and menopause.
What is meaning the menarche? Beginning of menstrual cycle, right? And as you have studied that before birth, there are 60,000 to 80,000 primary follicles.
Good evening.
There are 60,000 to 80,000 of primary follicles. So every month, the menstrual cycle, because it is called as cycle, it means it is occurring every month, cyclic. So every month from 60 to 80,000 of the primary follicle, the one follicle will mature and change into the ova. अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग टू रिमेम्बर, बिफोर बर्थ देयर आर 60,000 टू 80,000 ऑफ प्राइमरी फॉलिकल. व्हेन अ गर्ल अटेन द प्यूबर्टी, नाउ आउट ऑफ दो सो मेनी प्राइमरी फॉलिकल, एवरी मंथ वन प्राइमरी फॉलिकल विल मैच्योर इन सेकेंडरी फॉलिकल, टर्शरी फॉलिकल, एंड इट विल मेक द सेकेंडरी ओसाइट. Now, when you will study the menstrual cycle, this is a diagram. It is given in your NCERT book and very important diagram. Now, see at this side. It is written here, uterine event. These are ovarian hormone level. These are ovarian event and this is pituitary hormone level. These four things and here the number of days are written. Starting from day 1 to 29th day. In the female, this menstrual cycle is a cyclic period. In some women or the girl, it is of 28 days or 30 days. Means this process repeat every month. The first day to fifth day, it is written, it is called as the menstruation phase. This is also called as the bleeding phase, right? The second phase it is written, I'll explain one by one. The second is written follicular phase. The third is written luteal phase and the next cycle begin. So you can say ki within 1 month, these changes occur. This is menstruation phase, follicular phase, luteal phase and next cycle begin. Now what is the meaning of follicular phase? It is written proliferative phase. It means the primary follicles which are present in the ovary, they mature, proliferate, they mature here. Mature होने का मतलब है कि जो ये primary follicles form में थे, they will change into the secondary follicle, tertiary follicle, and finally it will make secondary oocyte, Graafian follicle and secondary oocyte. Now here, the one line you can see at the 14th day, this line indicate ki this is the day when secondary oocyte release from ovary. This is ovulation. The term is called as ovulation. So at which day ovulation occur? On which day? It is on 14th day. Before this, before release of secondary oocyte, the phase is called as proliferative phase, right? And next it is written as luteal phase. Agar aapko yaad ho to abhi maine bataya tha ki secondary oocyte jab release ho jata hai to uske baad jo bachi hui cell hoti hain, jo Graafian follicles hain, they make corpus luteum. Kya banati hain wo? Corpus. Here you can see in this diagram the corpus luteum. So that's why the name is called as luteal phase, right? So the names are clear here. This is called as menstruation. This is proliferative follicular phase. Then 14th day is a ovulation day. And then next 15th to next you can say 29 day. This is called as the luteal phase. Now what changes occur during these phases, these days? Uterine event. You can see ki kya changes uterus mein kya changes hote hain in dinon mein. So during first you can say in the menses phase or in the bleeding phase, the endometrium, ye kya dikhai hai? If you remember the layer, the different three layers in the uterus, can you name them? The three layer in the uterus, Sanjana, please give the name. पिछली बार क्लास में तुमने आंसर भी दिया था, पेरीमेट्रियम, मायोमेट्रियम एंड एंडोमेट्रियम. सार्थक, हेलो.
यस,
वेयर हैव यू गॉन फॉर सो मेनी डेज? इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस यू आर नॉट देयर. व्हाट हैपेंड?
यस मैम,
एवरीथिंग फाइन.
मैम तबीयत ठीक नहीं थी.
अच्छा, नाउ यू आर फाइन, एवरीथिंग इज गुड?
यस मैम.
Okay, yes, good, ma'am. Good. So there were the three layers in the uterus. you can simply see here three layer, the perimetrium, myometrium and endometrium, and you know the endometrium is glandular in nature and myometrium was muscular in nature. So what happened during those days during the menstrual cycle, simply you can say there is a rupturing of endometrium, the endometrium rupture, right? It has a blood vascular system, blood vessels are here, so they rupture and this is called as the bleeding phase. Then gradually, yes
ma'am, ye do phases ke beech mein jo gap hai usme kya hota hai ma'am?
Kahan pe gap hai beta?
Ma'am jab ye dono phases ke beech mein jo gap hai ma'am,
see beta, from 15 ye hai 1 to 5th day menstruation phase, then 5th to 13, 14 days it is a follicular phase, 14th day par beta there is a ovulation phase, 15th day se lekar 29th day tak this is called as the luteal phase or 30th day, then it will begin a new cycle. Fir yahan pe tum dobara se dekhoge there is a bleeding phase start ho raha hai, so there is no gap. Gap kahan pe aapko,
yes, kahan pe?
Now it is clear
ma'am, ye jo yes ma'am, yes ma'am,
clear,
yes ma'am,
theek hai, yahan endometrium rupture ho jati, fir uske baad dheere dheere endometrium kya ho rahi hai, it is growing. Why it is growing, give me the reason, endometrium is thickened here, bata sakte ho kya reason hota hai endometrium kyu thick hoti hai? Because the uterus prepare itself to receive the fertilized egg. यूट्रस का काम क्या होता है, जायगोट को इम्प्लांट करना, और अगर फर्टिलाइजेशन नहीं हुआ है, देयर इज नो जायगोट फॉर्मेशन, तो एंडोमेट्रियम दोबारा से रैप्चर हो जाती है. सो दिस फेज इज क्लियर बेटा, यूट्राइन इवेंट इज क्लियर. व्हाट हैपेंस ड्यूरिंग द मेंसेस फेज, क्या होता है मेंसेस फेज में एंडोमेट्रियम का, व्हाट हैपेंस टू एंडोमेट्रियम ड्यूरिंग दिस फेज, it rupture, it decreases rupture means yes this rupture along with the blood vessels, right? Then
yes,
gradually it is thickening, you can say ki it is thickening, as well as thickening is there, as well as more blood supply is there. What is the purpose for this? So that it can receive fertilized egg. Agar fertilization hota hai तो एंडोमेट्रियम अपने आप को पहले से प्रिपेयर करती है, सो दैट इम्प्लांटेशन कैन अकर. इम्प्लांटेशन मींस जो जायगोट बना है, इट विल कम एंड सेटल इनसाइड द यूट्रस, राइट? और इफ देयर इज नो फर्टिलाइजेशन, अगेन दिस एंडोमेट्रियम विल गेट रैप्चर एंड न्यू साइकिल विल बी बिगिन. नाउ ओवेरियन हॉर्मोन, ओवेरियन हॉर्मोन, देयर आर टू हॉर्मोन, द वन इज कॉल्ड एज ईस्ट्रोजन एंड प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन. ये तुमने क्लास टेंथ में भी थे, क्लास इलेवेंथ में सॉरी पढ़ के आए हो कि ओवरी रिलीज टू हार्मोन, द वन इज कॉल्ड ईस्ट्रोजन एंड अदर इज कॉल्ड एज प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन. व्हाट डिफरेंस यू कैन सी इन दिस ग्राफ, व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस इन ईस्ट्रोजन एंड प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन, बताओ कौन सा हार्मोन ओव्यूलेशन डे से पहले ज्यादा है और कौन सा ओव्यूलेशन के बाद है? विच हार्मोन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इज इंक्रीजिंग बिफोर ओव्यूलेशन? Yes, answer please.
Estrogen.
Estrogen.
Estrogen. So what is the role of estrogen? क्या role होगा estrogen का? Estrogen का काम होता है Graafian follicles को mature करना. जो primary follicles थी, वो primary follicle यहाँ तुम देख सकते हो ovarian event. Here primary oocyte, primary follicle, secondary follicle, tertiary follicle, Graafian follicle, and then there is a release of secondary oocyte. ये primary oocyte है. Clearly visible here? दिखाई दे रहा है बेटा ये?
Yes ma'am.
हाँ, तो इसमें estrogen का क्या role होगा? The role of estrogen is to mature the follicles so that the secondary oocyte, और यहाँ you can see clearly at the 14th day the egg is released from the ovary. Clear? Now rest of the cell, अब बाद में किसका इंक्रीज हो रहा है हार्मोन लेवल? प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन. यू कैन सी कि यहाँ प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन लेवल इज नॉट इंक्रीजिंग, बट आफ्टर ओव्यूलेशन द प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन लेवल इज इंक्रीजिंग. हु रिलीज प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन? कॉर्पस ल्यूटियम. कौन प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन रिलीज करता है? Who released? Corpus luteum. And what are corpus luteum?
Corpus luteum.
And what is corpus luteum? Corpus luteum है क्या बेटा? Ruptured graafian follicles. क्या है? Ruptured.
Ruptured graafian
follicles. So they make corpus luteum and these corpus luteum release the hormone progesterone. इसका रोल क्या होगा प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन का? इट मेंटेन प्रेगनेंसी. ये किसमें हेल्प करता है? मेंटेन प्रेगनेंसी. और अगर फर्टिलाइजेशन नहीं हुआ है तो क्या होगा? देयर विल बी रिग्रेशन. यू कैन से कि धीरे धीरे कॉर्पस ल्यूटियम भी रिग्रेस हो जाती हैं और लेवल इज डिक्रीजिंग. नाउ हियर यू कैन से प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन लेवल इज डिक्रीजिंग एंड अगेन द लेवल ऑफ ईस्ट्रोजन विल इंक्रीज. सो which hormone are these two? One is estrogen and progesterone. Name the hormone whose concentration increase before ovulation that help in the maturation of follicle.
Estrogen.
And after ovulation, progesterone. Role of progesterone. Role of progesterone maintaining pregnancy. Clear? So these events are related with this. It is clear? Now come to the pituitary hormone level. Pituitary hormone in male also you have studied.
Ma'am, corpus luteum kya karta hai ma'am? Corpus luteum kya hai ma'am?
Corpus luteum are remnant of graafian follicle. जैसे secondary oocyte है और उसके चारों तरफ बहुत सारी cell होती हैं. तो जब that is called as the graafian follicle. ठीक है, तो graafian follicle से secondary oocyte release हो गया और जो बाकी बची हुई cell हैं वो क्या बना देती हैं? corpus luteum बनाती हैं जो hormone release करता है. that's name of the hormone is progesterone that maintain the pregnancy. now clear?
yes ma'am.
yes. now come to the pituitary hormone level. these are the two hormone FSH and LH. one is FSH and other is LH. you can say LH. almost their level is same before ovulation. it is clear? but at 14th day you can say the slightly the LH level is high than FSH and this term is called as LH surge. isko hum kya bolte hain beta? LH surge. and that is
LH.
Surge. And this LH surge is mainly responsible for release of egg, or you can say this is responsible for ovulation. Though both hormone equally play the role, FSH and LH. FSH help in maturation. धीरे धीरे primary follicle mature हो रही हैं, graafian follicle बना रही हैं. But at the time, at the 14th day, the LH level becomes slightly higher than FSH, and this is called as LH surge that leads to the ovulation, right? And after that their level is also equal. there is no major change. so this diagram, particularly the whole diagram come in exam or sometime. what do they only give? they give this this diagram only, this middle one. they will write here A and B. so you have to identify which hormone is this, which hormone is this, right? so can you identify if in diagram it is asked?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you differentiate between ovarian hormone and pituitary hormone? अगर pituitary hormone यहाँ नहीं लिखा होता कई बार साइड में, तो आपको ये देखना है अगर दोनों हार्मोन लेवल एक जैसा है तो कौन से हार्मोन है? वो pituitary hormone. If there is one hormone,
pituitary hormone.
हाँ, pituitary. pituitary में भी LH is slightly more than FSH before ovulation. All these phases are clear to you? proliferative phase, luteal phase, next yes, cycle begin. so any doubt in this paragraph, in this diagram or in this process of menstrual cycle?
no,
clear? clear? Sanjana, do you have any doubt? do you have any doubt? no? okay, fine, very good. the next is fertilization and implantation. see, define the term fertilization. define the term fertilization. define karo beta. fusion of yes प्लीज म्यूट समवन यस गिव द आंसर डिफाइन द टर्म फर्टिलाइजेशन फ्यूजन
ऑफ मेल
गैमेट एंड फीमेल गैमेट एंड फीमेल गैमेट
fusion of male gamete and female gamete is called as fertilization. So what happened during the fertilization in human being? During the coitus or the intercourse, millions of the sperms are released in vagina, and these sperm passes through the cervix of uterus, reaches to ampullary isthmus junction of fallopian tube. First of all, you must understand that egg is released from the ovary, right? It is taken by the infundibulum.
Yes.
Anterior part kaun sa tha fallopian tube ka? Infundibulum, right? It has a structure that is called as fimbri. Have you see the diagram? These ovary 14th day, secondary oocyte released, fimbri receive this, reaches to infundibulum and finally reaches to ampullary isthmus junction. Similarly, the number of sperm passes through the different passes of the female genital structure, and they also reaches to ampullary isthmus junction. This is the place where fertilization occur in fallopian tube. Ampullary isthmus junction, जहां ये दोनों पार्ट आपस में ज्वाइन करते हैं, एट दिस पोर्शन पर्टिकुलरली द फर्टिलाइजेशन टेक्स प्लेस. बट वॉट चेंजेस अकर ड्यूरिंग द फर्टिलाइजेशन एंड वॉट आर द नीड? नाउ द ओवम इज ऑल्सो रिलीज इन द जंक्शन फॉर द फर्टिलाइजेशन टू अकर, एंड द फ्यूजन इज कॉल्ड एज फर्टिलाइजेशन. ड्यूरिंग फर्टिलाइजेशन द स्पर्म इंड्यूसेस changes in the zona pellucida and block the entry of other sperm. Now, very important thing, when you will see the diagram of ovum, you all have your NCERT books? Aapke paas NCERT books hai na?
No, ma'am.
No, you don't have the NCERT book.
Yeah,
just, ma'am. Acha, just no, wait for 1 minute. I'll open the another slide where the I have pasted the diagram. So just wait for a minute. I'll share. Fine.
Okay, ma'am.
I have opened a new share. Wait.
Ma'am, zona pellucida kya hai?
Wohi main dikha rahi hu beta. Theek hai?
Okay.
Module. Wait. Yes, now you can see the structure. This structure is visible to you now? Can you see the structure of ovum here?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay, only the previous slide is visible to you. Okay,
no,
I'll say. Okay, wait. Now I have shared. Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
You can see the structure of ovum? Yes. So now you can see here.
Yes, ma'am.
This is ovum. Now around this, on outer side, you can say there is a covering which is called as zona pellucida layer. It is visible to you? Zona pellucida, you can see?
Yes.
And outside of this,
yes,
there are other cell, and these cells are called as cells of corona radiata. This is the structure of ovum. This is ovum nuclei. You can say this is ovum nuclei, and outside of this ovum nuclei is a outside of ovum nuclei. Yes, there is a zona pellucida. And outside of zona pellucida, there are more layer of the cell which are called as cell of corona radiata. So what happens?
Radiata.
Yeah, what happen when there is an entry of sperm? So many sperms are getting the entry here. Only the one sperm come in contact with the passing through the corona radiata. This is connected with the zona pellucida, so there is a change in the permeability here some changes occur in the structure of this membrane and it doesn't allow the entry of more than one sperm. Means thousands of the sperm can be adhere here, and they how they digest the wall of zona pellucida. Do you remember in the structure of sperm? This head part, middle piece and tail. In the head, I told you specifically what is there. What is this pointed part of the head is called? Acrosome. Do you remember? Acrosome term. Acrosome that have the enzyme and this help in the digestion of the wall of zona pellucida. And as there is an entry of the one sperm head, immediately the secondary oocyte will complete its division and it will now called as ovum. And there is a change in the permeability also of this membrane, so it doesn't allow the entry of more than one sperm. So please tell me what event occur during the fertilization. What events occur during the fertilization period? Tell me. Where this event takes place? Name the place where this event takes place. What is the site of fertilization? What is the site of fertilization?
Ovary.
Fertilization ovary mein nahi hota beta. Fertilization kahan hota hai?
No ma'am.
Kahan hota hai fertilization? The site is Ampulla Isthmus Junction. What is the site? What is the site?
Ma'am, isthmus ampullary.
Ha, ampulla isthmus junction ya isthmus ampullary junction. Secondary oocyte reaches here. Number of sperm reaches there when the one sperm head enter through the zona pellucida. There is a meiosis second complete. उससे पहले मियोसिस वन ही किया होता है इसने सेकेंडरी ओसाइट स्टेज बनने पर, लेकिन जैसे ही स्पर्म का हेड इसके अंदर एंटर करता है इमीडिएटली इट कंप्लीट इट मियोसिस टू एंड इट मेक अ पोलर बॉडी एंड ओवम. नाउ व्हाट सेकंड चेंज अकर हियर? द सेकंड चेंज इज देयर इज अ चेंज इन द परमेबिलिटी ऑफ दिस मेम्ब्रेन ऑल्सो. इसकी जो मेम्ब्रेन की परमेबिलिटी भी चेंज हो जाती है, तो एक से ज्यादा स्पर्म इसके अंदर एंटर नहीं कर सकते. राइट, नाउ द थिंग्स आर क्लियर?
यस मैम.
आ गया है ना समझ में? फिर मैं और आगे फिर पढ़ाती हूँ, ठीक है?
यस
हाँ. नाउ कम व्हाट विल हैपन अब, और इसमें कौन है वॉल को कौन डाइजेस्ट कर रहा है? हु इज डाइजेस्टिंग द वॉल ऑफ ओवम? हु इज डाइजेस्टिंग? एक्रोसोम. वेरी गुड. एक्रोसोम में क्या है? विच केमिकल इज फिल्ड विद इन एक्रोसोम? देयर आर हाइड्रोलिटिक एंजाइम्स. क्या फिल्ड होते हैं इसमें? हाइड्रोलिटिक एंजाइम दैट डाइजेस्ट द वॉल ऑफ ओवम. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज फर्टिलाइजेशन इवेंट or implantation, a very important phenomena. Now you can first with the help of this diagram, you can concept map, you can understand sperm and ovum. They will fertilize. It will make a structure called as zygote. Ye kya banata hai? Zygote. And then the zygote then do the cleavage. Cleavage ka matlab hai, beta zygote kaisa hai? Single cell hai ya multi cell structure hai? Zygote कैसा स्ट्रक्चर होता है?
सिंगल सेल.
इट इज अ सिंगल सेल स्ट्रक्चर. और हमारी बॉडी कैसी है? कॉम्प्लेक्स बॉडी है. हमारे अंदर टिश्यू भी है, हमारे अंदर ऑर्गन्स भी हैं. तो क्या होता है इस समय, ये जो zygote है सिंगल सेल है, इट डू क्लीवेज. क्लीवेज का मतलब है बेटा कि ये सिर्फ इंटरनल डिवीजन करता है, बाहर से zygote से सेल अलग अलग नहीं होती. अगर if anyway these cell get separated then they will make two individual. Agar zygote mein pehla division ho, mitosis division ho, to ek cell se do cell banegi aur wo do alag alag zygote ban jayenge aur unse do individual banenge. To what exactly happen that zygote do the cleavage. नॉट द डिवीजन. समझ आ रहा है? इंटरनली इट डिवाइड.
यस मैम.
Internally divide and make number of cell which are called as blastomeres. क्या बोलते हैं उन cells को? Blastomere. There are two
blastomere.
Cells. Blastomere. They make first two cell, then four cell, eight cells, 16 cell. And the structure is called as morula. जब एक साथ बहुत सारी cell बन जाती हैं, 16 cell stage बन जाती हैं, तो it looks like a mulberry. Mulberry you all know. So that's why the name of stage is called as morula stage. After morula, there is blastocyst stage. Which stage is there? Blastocyst stage. Now I'll show you the diagram here. See here. This is secondary oocyte. Clear? Now the sperm is getting the entry and
yes,
now there is fertilization ho gaya. Fertilization ho ke ye kya bana? Zygote bana. Now you can say there is a cleavage. Bahar ki wall inki apne aap hai aur andar isne kitni cell banai? Two cells.
Do
cell banai hai. Do se char cell stage banai hai. And then four se eight, eight to 16 cell jab ban jati hai. So this stage is called as morula stage.
Morula.
Because it looks like mulberry. Is it clear? Then what happens?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Now you can see here. Ye, this stage now. In the next stage, what happens? कि ये जो cell है सारी, वो सारी cell अपने आप को दो layer में arrange कर रही हैं. You can see the some cell they are making the outermost boundary and few cell are adhere at one place. Can you see this diagram? Now this
yes, ma'am.
This is called as blastocyst. क्या है ये? Blastocyst. And the outer layer is called as trophoblast. And this group of cell is called as cell of inner mass. All the cell in the morula, morula ke baad agli stage banti hai blastula stage. The cells are called as blastocyst. They arrange them into two layer. The outer layer is trophoblast and some cell which are present at one place, they are called as cell of inner mass. अब इनमें क्या डिफरेंस है दोनों में? बेटा ये जो बाहर वाली सेल है ट्रोफोब्लास्ट सेल है, ये सेल यूट्रस में जाकर अटैचमेंट का काम करती हैं, ये सेल प्लेसेंटा बनाती हैं. तुमने टेंथ क्लास में पढ़ा होगा द प्लेसेंटा, पढ़ा था टेंथ क्लास में? व्हाट इज प्लेसेंटा? दैट हेल्प टू मेक द कनेक्शन विद फीटस एंड मदर यूट्रस. तो हु इज हेल्पिंग टू एडहेयर the embryo inside the uterus, these are the trophoblast cell. और जो ये cell है जिनको cell of inner mass कहते हैं, these are also called as stem cell. They make embryo. क्या बनाती हैं ये? Embryo. And at this stage, blastocyst stage, you can see it is written here. देखो A, B, C, यहां से यहां fertilization हुआ, धीरे धीरे move हुआ, and finally in the GH stage, you can say this is a G stage. It is resembling to this or not? This stage is resembling to this. And finally, there is a implantation. Implantation means now the blastocyst, they have come inside the uterus and they are getting adhere there. Can you now, is it clear or should I explain it again? The changes which occur, event which occur during the fertilization, you just see here, sperm come in the contact with zona pellucida and there is a change in the membrane that block the entry of additional sperm. Secretion of acrosome help sperm enter to the cytoplasm of ovum. Meiotic division of secondary oocyte. Haploid ovum and second polar body form. And then finally there is a formation of zygote. Can you tell me the meaning of all these six lines? Ye abhi maine pehle padhaya tha. Aaya ye samajh mein nahi? Acha ye batao. At which stage? The egg is released from ovary. At which stage the egg secondary oocyte? चलो ये meiosis one होता है या meiosis two के बाद बनता है? When does it form?
Meiosis one के.
Meiosis.
Meiosis two.
Meiosis one के बाद क्या बनता है? Secondary oocyte. ठीक है? और इसका meiosis two कब होता है बेटा? when it do its meiosis two? When there is a entry of sperm. जब स्पर्म की एंट्री होती है तब ये कौन सा अपना डिवीजन कंप्लीट करता है? मियोसिस टू. और देन इट इज कॉल्ड एज ओवम. व्हाट इवेंट्स अकर ड्यूरिंग फर्टिलाइजेशन? फर्टिलाइजेशन में क्या क्या इवेंट्स होते हैं?
जायगोट.
हाँ,
जायगोट एम्ब्रियोजेनेसिस.
जायगोट एंड एम्ब्रियोजेनेसिस, वेरी गुड. अच्छा, जायगोट फॉर्मेशन के बाद पहली स्टेज कौन सी होती है?
सेल डिवीजन.
सेल डिवीजन, अच्छा, सेल डिवीजन है और इट इज अ सेल क्लीवेज. आर द सेल गेटिंग सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम ईच अदर? क्या ये सेल एक दूसरे से अलग हो जाते
हैं? नो.
They do not get separated from each other and internally they divide only, right? इनमें कैसा division है? Internal division है. अगर ये अलग अलग हो जाएंगी, yes. अगर ये अलग अलग हो जाएंगी तो क्या बनेगा?
Ma'am, those
twins. Yes, there will be a formation of twins. ठीक है, जो identical twins बनते हैं ना. Identical twins, yes, whether they are two boy, two girl, resembling each other, they are formed like this. कि they are developed from a single zygote. और अगर दो sperm और दो egg fuse होते हैं, तो वो अलग तरह के twins बनते हैं. They are called as fraternal twins. They may be two brother, two like other sibling, one boy, one girl. Any change can be occur in them, right? So you can see here.
Yes, ma'am.
So all these stages are clear to you. Cleavage, 2 to 4 cell stage, 8 to 16 cell stage. Now the stage, it is called as morula stage. Then morula change into the blastula. The cells are called blastocyst. Blastocyst mein outer layer ka naam batao jaldi se. What is the name?
Trophoblast.
This is trophoblast. Very good, Sanjana. Trophoblast. And the these rest of the cell are called?
Cell of inner mass.
Cell of inner mass. Good. What is the role of trophoblast? Role.
Attached to the uterus.
Very good. It helps to attach this to the uterus wall. And what do the cell of inner mass form?
Ma'am, ovum.
They make embryo. क्या बनाते हैं? ओवम तो बेटा बन चुका, ओवम तो फर्टिलाइज हो चुका. ये क्या फॉर्म करते हैं? एम्ब्रियो. इट फॉर्म द एम्ब्रियो. यहां तक समझ आ गया है? एंड इम्प्लांटिंग ऑफ दिस इनसाइड द यूट्रस इज कॉल्ड एज इम्प्लांटेशन. क्या कहलाता है ये? इम्प्लांटेशन. क्लियर? शुड आई मूव फर्दर?
यस मैम.
यस, नाउ सी दिस डायग्राम. दीज आर एंडोमेट्रियम. ये क्या दिख रही है? एंडोमेट्रियम लेयर है. ये सेल ऑफ इनर मास है, ये ट्रोफोब्लास्ट है, एंड दिस इज कैविटी. सो व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन इट कम इनटू द यूट्रस? द एंडोमेट्रियम कवर देम. ये पूरी तरह एंडोमेट्रियम में जाके एम्बेडेड हो जाती हैं. द ब्लास्टोमियर, द ब्लास्टोसिस्ट गेट एम्बेडेड इन द एंडोमेट्रियम ऑफ यूट्रस. पूरी तरह यहाँ इसमें एम्बेडेड हो जाती हैं बिल्कुल जाकर. एंड दिस टर्म इज कॉल्ड एज इम्प्लांटेशन. एंड नाउ द यूट्राइन सेल रैपिडली डिवाइड. और ये सेल क्या करेंगी? डिवाइड करेंगी और इसको पूरी तरह से कवर कर लेती हैं. नाउ इट गेट इम्प्लांटेड इनसाइड द यूट्रस एंड फर्दर
फर्स्ट लेयर कौन सी होती है?
किस कौन सी
फर्स्ट लेयर कौन सी होती है मैम?
किसकी फर्स्ट लेयर बेटा?
यूटेरस की.
पेरिमेट्रियम दैट इज आउटर मोस्ट. ठीक है, मायोमेट्रियम दैट इज मिडिल वन, एंड एंडोमेट्रियम. एंडोमेट्रियम तो ये अंदर की तरफ. इम्प्लांटेशन तो अंदर की तरफ होगा ना बेटा? एंडोमेट्रियम में होगा ना?
यस मैम.
हां, सो दे गेट एम्बेडेड हियर. नाउ फर्दर एम्ब्रियोनिक डेवलपमेंट टेक्स प्लेस. और जब इम्प्लांटेशन हो जाता है देन द फीमेल इज कंसीडर्ड एज अ प्रेग्नेंट. अब ना मुझे हार्मोन का नाम बताओ जल्दी से. विच हार्मोन प्ले द इम्पोर्टेंट रोल इन मेंटेनिंग प्रेगनेंसी?
प्रोजेस्टेरोन.
वेरी गुड. हु रिलीज प्रोजेस्टेरोन?
ओवेरियन
हु रिलीज प्रोजेस्टेरोन महेश
मैम
सार्थक मृत्युंजय
मैम ओवरी
ओवरी तो करती
प्लेसेंटा
प्लेसेंटा क्यों रिलीज करेगा प्रोजेस्टेरोन नो अभी मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल में मैं पढ़ा के चुकी हूँ कि जो रेमिनेंट ऑफ ग्रेफियन फॉलिकल्स होती हैं वो क्या कहलाती हैं कॉर्पस ल्यूटियम पढ़ा था अभी
कॉर्पस ल्यूटियम यस मैम यस मैम
भूल गए ना तो कॉर्पस ल्यूटियम क्या रिलीज करती थी प्रोजेस्टेरोन क्या रिलीज करती है
प्रोजेस्टेरोन
नाउ सी व्हाट फर्दर चेंजेस विल अकर द इनर लेयर grow out as finger-like projection called villi in the uterine stroma. धीरे धीरे क्या होता है कि जो ट्रोफोब्लास्ट है ट्रोफोब्लास्ट से थोड़ी थोड़ी फिंगर जैसी स्ट्रक्चर फॉर्म होने लगती है एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड एज कोरियोनिक विलाय क्या कहलाती है ये कोरियोनिक विलाय एंड नाउ द प्लेसेंटा सीक्रीट नंबर ऑफ हॉर्मोन्स दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एच सी जी HPL, human placental lactogen, human chorionic gonadotropin, estrogen hormone and progesterone hormone. Right? These are the important hormones which are released by placenta. HCG, human chorionic...
HCG ka full form?
Human chorionic gonadotropin. कोरियोनिक विलाय जब विलाय का फॉर्मेशन हो जाएगा ना बेटा प्लेसेंटास के साथ देन दे रिलीज द हार्मोन जो मार्केट में जो प्रेगनेंसी किट होती है उसमें जो टेस्ट किया जाता है द टेस्ट इज डन फॉर दिस हार्मोन एचसीजी कोरियोनिक गोनेडोट्रोपिन ह्यूमन प्लेसेंटल लैक्टोजन ईस्ट्रोजन एंड प्रोजेस्टेरोन दे आर ऑल हार्मोन्स आर रिक्वायर्ड टू मेंटेन द प्रेगनेंसी प्लेसेंटा इज कॉल्ड एज अ एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड Why? Can you tell me why it is called endocrine? What is the role of endocrine gland? Release hormone. So, yahan hormone release kar raha hai ya nahi placenta? It is releasing yes, hormone. So, that's why it is called birth. The placenta is a temporary endocrine gland. Why it is temporary?
Ma'am, kyunki wo matlab जब
ओनली व्हेन द फीमेल इज प्रेग्नेंट
तभी तो
हाँ ओनली व्हेन द फीमेल इज प्रेग्नेंट ओनली दैट टाइम द प्लेसेंटा विल बी फॉर्म ना नॉट ऑलवेज सो दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज टेम्पररी ग्लैंड नाउ द इनर सेल मास अब क्या होगा ये एम्बेडेड हो गया पूरी तरह कोरियोनिक विलाय बन गई सब कुछ हो गया अब बाकी रोल क्या होता है इनर सेल मास का जो क्या करती है दीज इनर सेल मास हेल्प इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एम्ब्रियो दे विल मेक द जर्म लेयर ये बनाती है एक्टोडर्म मीजोडर्म एंडोडर्म एंड फ्रॉम दीज जर्म लेयर देयर आर द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ऑर्गन्स ऑर्गेनोजेनेसिस स्टार्ट So, all these things are clear? Or any doubt? Should I repeat anything
yes,
else?
Ma'am.
समझ आ गया है?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Now you can see here. This is a cavity of uterus. These are endometrium layer where they are embedded. Now these are placental villi, chorionic villi. And the embryo is connected with the chorionic villi or the placental villi with the help of umbilical cord with its vessel. And this is the plug of mucus in cervix. The plug of mucus in cervix that only open when there is a this embryo is fully developed. This diagram is in your NCERT book and it is generally asked to draw, not to draw, to level only. What is this umbilical cord? You can say the embryo is connected with the placenta. Placenta make the connection with the endometrium. It get integrated and there is a exchange. Placenta ka kaam kya hota hai? Exchange of material. It takes the food, it takes the oxygen and give out the waste material. Now the feature of embryonic development, this is called as the gestation period. Human mein जो गेस्टेशन पीरियड है दिस इज ऑफ 9 मंथ यू ऑल नो that during this 9 month there the embryo is fully formed and then only the birth takes place. So the term gestation means the development period. How much is this? 9 months.
Nine months.
Yes. And the whole gestation period is divided into three trimester. Three trimester ka matlab hai ki three months. The first 3 months, it is a first trimester. Second, fourth, fifth, sixth, it is a second trimester. Seventh, eighth, and 9 months, this is a third trimester. And different changes takes place during this period in the embryo. जो पूरा एम्ब्रियोनिक डेवलपमेंट होता है वो इन्हीं 9 months में कंप्लीट होता है. नाउ यू कैन से इन द फर्स्ट मंथ एम्ब्रियो हार्ट इज फॉर्म्ड. इट इज द फर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑर्गन. सबसे पहले एम्ब्रियो में जो बनने वाला ऑर्गन है वो क्या है? हार्ट. एंड इट फॉर्म्स इन द फर्स्ट मंथ. सो दैट्स व्हाई द डॉक्टर्स कैन इजिली डिटेक्ट द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द फीटस. यू हैव सीन in the movies also that the doctor is testing a pregnant lady by putting a stethoscope on the abdomen region. So what do actually they do? They hear the fetal heartbeat, right? So the first month embryo heart is formed. In the second month there is a fetus developed. It's limbs and digit. Limbs and digit का मतलब है कि hands और legs का formation होता है, उसमें fingers का formation हो जाता है. And you can say in the third trimester, 12th week, major organ system are formed. Means during this period, the embryo has all its organ, even the genital organs. So that's why sometime, though it is not allowed to determine the sex of unborn fetus, but in certain centers they allow to do this, and it is done after completion of the first trimester, because at that time the male and female genital organ has been formed. So they can easily detect by sonography, by ultrasound, whether the developing fetus is male or female. And if they do not want the female fetus or male fetus, then they go for the termination of pregnancy. So the first trimester, you can say the major organ systems are formed. Then fifth month, the movement in the fetus start, appearance of hair on head, as well as the completion of second trimester, the body is covered with fine hair, eyelid open, eyelid separates, and the eyelashes also form. So appearance of hair occurs at that time, you can say till the second trimester. In the sixth month, almost the baby has been developed. The growth takes place in the third trimester. At this time, it's grow. So in case of immature birth, you can say premature birth, all 7 month or 8 month the child birth takes place, then they have all the organ, everything is there. Only the thing is ki they are very weak, because it is the third trimester is a mainly period where the growth takes place. The development has already completed. So gestation is clear. What is gestation? What is gestation?
Yes, ma'am.
Gestation clear?
Yes, ma'am.
When does the human heart is formed? A human heart carrier. Embryo heart is formed?
In first month. Of gestation period.
When all the complete organs, genital organs are formed? In first trimester. All the organs has formed. ठीक है? And now what will happen jab gestation period pura ho jata hai, then the childbirth occur, and this term is called as parturition. Kya bolte hain isko? This is called parturition.
Parturition.
Yes, the parturition is a process of taking birth of embryo or the fetus. Fine. The gestation period is 9 months. Parturition is a process of delivery of the fetus. Now, how does it takes place? A very important term. Remember this: fetal ejection reflex. In 1 mark, it comes, or the whole process is asked for 3 marks. Fetal ejection reflex. When the fetus is fully formed or fully developed, puri tarah develop hota hai, then this fetus as well as the placenta, it form the signal to brain. Until unless it is not fully formed, the fetus will not send any signal. It is a neuroendocrine mechanism. Childbirth is a neuroendocrine mechanism. Iska matlab bataoge beta? Neuroendocrine mechanism. Neuro means it is related with the brain. Endocrine, it is related with the hormone. So fully formed fetus as well as placenta, it send the signal to the brain, and this is called as fetal ejection reflex. Because brain kya karta hai fir? Brain send the signal to uterus to contract. Uterus ki kaun si layer thi jo muscular thi? Which layer of uterus was muscular? Myometrium. तो क्या होगा फिर? Now the signal of parturition originate from fully developed fetus and placenta, and it induce mild uterine contraction called as the fetal ejection reflex. Now what happens due to this fetal ejection reflex? Due to this, the oxytocin hormone is released by pituitary. Have you heard the name of this oxytocin hormone? Suna hai pehle kabhi aapne oxytocin?
Which is,
that is called as a birth hormone. Ye kya kehlata hai? Birth hormone. To kya hoga ki jaise hi brain signal dega pituitary ko, and pituitary will release the hormone oxytocin. Oxytocin se uterus contraction vigorous ho jati hai, and finally the child, the fetus, you can say, the take birth through the birth canal. So oxytocin act on uterine muscles, cause stronger uterine contraction, which is turn stimulate further secretion of oxytocin, and there is a, you can say, the birth of the fully formed fetus. Clear hai? Yahan tak samajh aa gaya hai? Aaya beta samajh mein?
Yes, ma'am.
Name the hormone which help in childbirth.
Oxytocin, ma'am.
Yes. Name the gland which release oxytocin.
Pituitary gland.
Pituitary. Who send the signal to brain? Who send the signal to brain for birth? Fully formed fetus. Fully formed fetus as well as placenta. कौन सिग्नल भेजता है ब्रेन को ऑक्सीटोसिन रिलीज करने के लिए? Fully formed fetus as well as and placenta. Clear है?
Placenta.
Now after the childbirth, the last topic है chapter का, there lactation. Lactation means release of the milk, right, from the mammary gland for feeding the young one. The mammary gland also, तुमने पढ़ा था अभी, एक हार्मोन था HPL हार्मोन, ह्यूमन प्लेसेंटल लैक्टोजन. व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ HPL? इट हेल्प इन द ग्रोथ ऑफ मेमरी ग्लैंड. व्हेन अ फीमेल, हाँ, व्हेन द फीमेल इज प्रेग्नेंट, एट दिस टाइम द ग्रोथ ऑफ मेमरी ग्लैंड ऑल्सो टेक्स प्लेस. नाउ आफ्टर द चाइल्ड बर्थ द लैक्टेशन स्टार्ट. लैक्टेशन मीन्स सिक्रीशन ऑफ मिल्क स्टार्ट, राइट. The mammary gland undergo to the differentiation during pregnancy and start producing milk towards the end of pregnancy by the process called as lactation. The initial days of the milk which is secreted by the female, it is called as colostrum. A very important term to remember, ki initial jo milk hota hai jo mother secrete karti hai, that is called as colostrum. And this colostrum play a very important role. The reason, because it has number of antibodies. Is colostrum ke andar bahut sare antibodies hote hain, mainly the immunoglobulin A usko bolte hain. Wo agle chapter mein bhi tum padhoge, but remember this, the colostrum consists number of antibodies that provide protection to the young one. Bacche ko immunity kahan se milti hai? Child, infant ko kahan se immunity milti hai? Immunity from the mother's milk. Right. So, what is colostrum?
milk produced during initial days.
The milk which is produced by initial days of lactation, right? It consists yes, colostrum, and this colostrum is a good source of antibodies, and it help to develop the resistance for the disease in the newborn baby. So this is all about the second chapter. This is all about the second chapter from beginning. Just for at a glance, I can tell you. देखो बेटा, तुमने इसमें पढ़ा spermatogenesis, oogenesis. A quick response I want to listen from you. These two process are clear? समझ आ गई थी? एक spermatogonia से.
मैं नहीं था.
अच्छा, सार्थक तुम नहीं थे, है ना? महेश, you were there?
Yes, ma'am.
अच्छा.
नहीं, ma'am.
मृत्युंजय
मैं नहीं था.
अच्छा, महेश भी नहीं था, तुम भी नहीं थे, तो कौन किसने सारा पूरा चैप्टर किसने अटेंड किया है बेटा? संजना, सो हाउ विल यू देन स्टडी? तो बड़ा मुश्किल होगा स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस. योर वॉइस इज ब्रेकिंग बेटा. सो सार्थक So what I can do, see beta, in the next class I'll start the next chapter, but before this ek baar main in processes ko dobara se tumhe wo kar dungi, lekin yahan samajh lo. Waise spermatogonia are the main cell which produce the sperm. First of all they do mitosis division, they make primary spermatocyte. Uske baad wo first meiotic division karti hain, then secondary spermatocyte. अब चूंकि meiosis तो दो पार्ट में कंप्लीट होता है, meiosis 1 एंड meiosis 2. When do they do meiosis 2? Then they make spermatids, and after differentiation they change into spermatozoa. तो one spermatogonia will produce 4 spermatozoa. You can see here the difference, कि one spermatogonia 4 spermatozoa. लेकिन यहाँ जब oogenesis देखोगे तो from in oogenesis the oogonia is making only one ovum. This is the difference or not? Can you correlate with this to the reproduction in flowering plant also?
Yes, ma'am.
क्या था उसमें भी, क्या था कि एक microspore mother cell से 4 pollen grain बनते थे ना, pollen tetrad. Yes, बट फीमेल में कितने एम्ब्रियो सेक में कितने एग का फॉर्मेशन हुआ था? वन एग फॉर्मेशन ओनली. वन एग फॉर्मेशन वाज देयर. दूसरे डिफरेंसेस एनीवन एल्स हु कैन टेल मी? स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस और ओजेनेसिस का दूसरा डिफरेंस बताओ बेटा.
मैम प्राइमरी स्पर्मेटोसाइट्स में हम दो इसमें
नहीं, ये बताया था कि स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस अकर इन मेल आफ्टर प्यूबर्टी ओनली. कब होती है? इन प्यूबर्टी ओनली, प्यूबर्टी के बाद. और ओजेनेसिस कब स्टार्ट हो जाती है? इट स्टार्ट बिफोर बर्थ, व्हेन अ फीमेल फीटस इज ग्रोइंग इनसाइड द मदर यूट्रस, इवन दैट टाइम इट स्टार्ट. समझ आया क्या डिफरेंस है? कब शुरू होती है ओजेनेसिस? कब स्टार्ट होती है? बिफोर बर्थ, बर्थ से पहले. व्हेन द फीमेल चाइल्ड इज ग्रोइंग इनसाइड द मदर यूट्रस. ये चार फेज ये तो मैंने आज पढ़ाए हैं. ये पता है ये मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल के 4 फेजेस क्लियर हैं? यू हैव स्टडीड टुडे ओनली ना? अच्छा, मुझे ये बताओ एट विच डे ओवम इज रिलीज? क्विक, at which days? On which days? On 14th day. Name the hormone that level is very high that cause the ovulation. 14th day kaun sa hormone? Which one, Mrityunjay?
Estrogen.
No, estrogen, progesterone. No estrogen, no progesterone. Yaad karo.
Corpus luteum.
No, this is also wrong.
No. बलेस के बाद जो था.
कौन सा था? सबसे दो हार्मोन थे जिन दोनों का लेवल एक LH, which hormone was that?
FSH and LH, ma'am.
LH था, ये दिखा था ना? दिखाया था ना मैंने LH कि LH level is increased, so that's why it is called LH surge. इसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? LH surge. That is mainly responsible for release of egg. Which hormone is increased during follicular phase? कौन सा हार्मोन है जो फॉलिकुलर फेज में बहुत ज्यादा होता है? FSH और ईस्ट्रोजन या प्रोजेस्टेरॉन?
ईस्ट्रोजन.
ईस्ट्रोजन. और ओव्यूलेशन के बाद?
प्रोजेस्टेरॉन.
कॉर्पस ल्यूटियम कौन सा हार्मोन सीक्रेट करते हैं? प्रोजेस्टेरॉन. राइट,
प्रोजेस्टेरॉन.
हाँ, देन अच्छा, कैन यू टेल मी द आउटर मोस्ट लेयर, इसका नाम बताओगे? इस लेयर का नाम क्या है? व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ दिस लेयर वेयर माय कर्सर इज?
इनर मास.
ये इनर मास नहीं है, इनर मास तो ये है बेटा. ये क्या
है? ट्रोफोब्लास्ट.
ट्रोफोब्लास्ट, वेरी गुड. ट्रोफोब्लास्ट. अच्छा, हु प्रिवेंट द एंट्री ऑफ सो मेनी स्पर्म? यहाँ क्या होता है, बहुत सारे स्पर्म एग के अंदर क्यों नहीं जा पाते?
मैम क्योंकि जो कोरोना रेडिएटर है वो
कोरोना रेडिएटर नहीं, जैसे ही एक स्पर्म की हेड की एंट्री होती है, जोना पेलिसुडा मेम्ब्रेन की परमेबिलिटी चेंज हो जाती है. ठीक है, देयर इज अ चेंज इन द कॉम्पोजिशन ऑफ जोना पेलिसुडा. कोरोना रेडिएटर में चेंज नहीं होता बेटा, जोना पेलिसुडा में. सो दैट ब्लॉक द एंट्री ऑफ एडिशनल स्पर्म. राइट, ओके. और इस डायग्राम से और मुझे इस डायग्राम में अच्छा लास्ट में बताया था लैक्टेशन में जो इनिशियल डेज ऑफ मिल्क इज कॉल्ड
क्या? कोलोस्ट्रम.
कोलोस्ट्रम, वेरी गुड. द फर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑर्गन इज
मैम हार्ट.
हार्ट. व्हाट इज द, यस, what is fetal ejection reflex? This is my next question, then I'll wind up the session. So revise all those things. Batao, last question is what is fetal ejection reflex?
Ma'am, that gives signals for childbirth.
That give the fully formed fetus. Yes, very good. Fully formed fetus and placenta send a signal to brain. Brain will give signal to pituitary. Pituitary will release oxytocin that will cause the contraction in uterus muscles. So fine. So just revise this. All these things today we have done. And you don't actually note down your queries. When I begin the session, in the next class, I would like to ask the question from you. If you have studied the topic, what problem you are facing, then I will move to the next topic only. So clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So should yes, I? Ma'am. So now we will wind up our session. Anything else? Anything else?
No.
Okay.
No, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. Then bye. Fine. Okay.
Bye. Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, welcome. So I'll stop sharing.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, bye, beta. Bye. Yes.